Today, let us start with this SEBI ICDR regulations. See, your syllabus in SEBI consists of two portions. It consists of SEBI Act and it consists of SEBI regulations. Your syllabus consists of SEBI Act and SEBI regulations. SEBI Act, it's a very, very simple act. Majority of the act contains provisions relating to penalties. For what type of misdeed, what type of penalties to be levied. So I'll give it as notes. You can just go through. There is nothing to discuss in SEBI Act. But SEBI regulations are very, very voluminous. There are very many things to be discussed in SEBI regulations. If you take the SEBI regulation, the bare text of the regulation itself runs for somewhere around 150 to 160 pages. So we will take the SEBI regulation for discussion now. We will try to complete some 30 to 40% today. And if possible in the afternoon session, whatever is left over in that FEMA relating to that, that we will complete. Then if time permits, again we will jump to SEBI and like this we will proceed. This SEBI regulations it speaks about the following. SEBI regulations contains provisions relating to the following. Where a company is making a public issue of shares, where the company is making a public issue of shares, or where the company is making rights issue, where the company is making rights issue and the issue value is greater than rupees 50 lakhs, where it is making rights issue and the issue value is greater than rupees 50 lakhs, where it is making bonus issue, where the company is making bonus issue, or where the company is making QIP. What is this QIP? QIP is Qualified Institutional Placement. So QIP stands for Qualified Institutional Placement Program. QIP stands for Qualified Institutional Placement Program. Similarly, where the company is making any issue of IDR, company is making an issue of IDR. IDR means what? Indian Depository Receipts. Just like we have got ADR, GDR, we also have this IDR, Indian Depository Receipts. So if the company is making any of these issues, they should comply with the provisions which are given in this SEBI regulations. So this is the basic regulation. Regulation number 3 says, where the company is making any of these issues, it shall comply with this SEBI regulations. Now I am proceeding, friends. Regulation number 4 is the next regulation. It speaks about certain restrictions. It speaks about certain restrictions. What restriction it is speaking about? Very simple. It says certain persons cannot issue shares as per this regulations. Certain persons, they cannot issue shares. So I can either call this as a restriction or I can call this as an eligibility requirement. If I should call it positively, I say it is an eligibility requirement. If I should say negatively, I will say that this is a restriction. So what are the restrictions or what are the eligibility requirements that are placed here? It says the following. Eligibility number 1, the company or the promoter or the promoter group, the company, the promoter group, the directors, person in control, these persons, they should not have been debarred by the SEBI from entering into capital market. If any of these persons are debarred from entering into capital market, then these persons, they cannot go for a public issue, or it cannot issue any shares or debentures to the public. See, which means occasionally what happens when any complaint is made to SEBI, SEBI will investigate all those activities and the SEBI may debar certain persons from entering into the capital market. So if the SEBI is debarring the company, or no sir, SEBI is not debarring the company, SEBI is debarring the promoter, or it is debarring the promoter group as such, or it is debarring any director, or it is debarring any person in control, now this company shall not go for an issue. This is restriction number one. Or to put it negatively, the eligibility is, you should not have been debarred from entering into the capital market. Number two, where the promoter, or I'll say this way, where there is a company, this company is debarred from entering into capital market. This company is debarred from entering into capital market. Now the promoter group, the directors, the person in control, of this company, now the promoter or the promoter group or the person in control or the directors of this company, if they are promoters or directors or promoter group or person in control of any other company, if they are promoter or promoter group or director or person in control of any other company, this company also shall not make a public issue. This company also shall not make a public issue. Which means, first sollapattad enna na, what was mentioned here, where the company itself is directly debarred from entering into capital market, or the promoter is debarred, or the promoter group is debarred, like this, any of these persons are debarred. Now these persons cannot enter into capital market. Second scenario, the promoter, promoter group or director or person in control are not debarred, but they may be acting as promoter or so and so in some other company, no? For example, X Limited is there. For example, X Limited is there. X Limited is debarred from entering into capital market, and the promoters are not debarred. Now what happens? The promoters of this company, if they are acting as promoters of your company also shall not make a public issue. Are you all following, friends? Yes, sir. So this is the next regulation. Now I am proceeding. Number C, where a company is there, this company, it is proposing issue of debt securities. This company is proposing issue of debt securities, but this company has not paid principal or interest on any debt. They have not paid principal or interest on any debt for a period exceeding 6 months. They have not paid principal or interest on any debt for a period exceeding 6 months. And it has been notified by the RBI in the list of willful defaulters. It has been notified by the RBI in the list of willful defaulters. Here, what you should understand, periodically RBI will come out with a statement. These are all the persons who are willful defaulters. Like this, RBI will inform the public with a set of persons. So where the company is notified by the RBI in the list of willful defaulters, now this company is not eligible to make a now this company is not eligible to make a public issue. This is the next provision to be understood. Next, where there are any partly paid up shares, where there are any partly paid up shares, this company cannot go for a public issue. The company cannot go for a public issue in the case of partly paid up shares unless these shares are converted into fully paid up shares. Very, very logical, no? Already you are having partly paid up shares. First call from the existing shareholders. If that fund is not sufficient, you can raise the additional capital from the outside public. Next, this company, it shall make arrangements. The company shall make arrangements with depositories to dematerialize these shares. The company shall make arrangements with the depositories for the purpose of dematerialization of the shares. So this is one of the precondition for a company to go for a public issue. You should have entered into some contract with the depositories. Already I have told you about the depositories, yes or not? There are two depositories in India, NSDL and CDSL. They are the two depositories in India. Now the company, what it should do, you should enter into some agreement or arrangement with the depositories so as to dematerialize your shares. Similarly, can I proceed, friends? Similarly, the company shall approach the stock exchange and it shall get approval or in principle approval for listing. The company shall approach the stock exchange and it should get the approval or in principle approval for listing of its shares. Last condition is firm arrangement is made through verifiable finance or through verifiable means of finance firm arrangement is made through verifiable means of finance for financing this for financing the project cost excluding the public issue. However, it is sufficient if you have made a firm arrangement to project or to finance 75% of the project cost excluding public issue. Understood? Listen, I'll give you an illustration. Ipo X Limited is there. X Limited is there. What X Limited is doing, it is going to construct a cement factory. It is going to construct a cement factory. The total project cost is 1300 crores. The total project cost for the cement factory is 1300 crores. Now what happens? It is going in for a public issue for 1000 crores. It is going in for a public issue to the extent of 1000 crores. Now friends, tell me, this out of these 1300 crores, 1000 crores is taken care by the public issue. Now what is the balance amount? 300 crores. Now what the company should do, out of this 300 crores, out of this 300 crores, 75% of this 300 crores na, it comes to 225, yeah. 75% na comes to 225, yeah. Sorry. 225 crores ke, it should show a verifiable means of finance. ₹225 crores ke, verifiable means of finance is to be shown, which means, sir, see, we are already having fixed deposits to the extent of 150 crores. We are going to liquidate that fixed deposit. We are already having investments to the extent of another 80-90 crores. We are going to liquidate that investments. See, if the entire project cost, if you are going to rise through public issue, that is not a problem, yes or not? But where, if you are not going to raise the entire project cost through public issue, now there is a problem. What is the problem? The problem is that, in case, if you are not able to get this balance 300 crores, in case if you are not going to get the balance 300 crores, the project becomes a failure, yes or not? Not only the project becomes a failure, the public issue also becomes a failure. Unnecessarily you have collected money from the public, but you don't know how to use that money because you are running short of balance 300 crores. So thereby what the regulation says, in case to the portion, to the extent which is not financed by the public issue, how are you going to meet that deficit? How are you going to meet that shortage? For that you should give the verifiable sources of finance at least to the extent of 75%. This regulation or this provision, when it will apply, sir, only when I am not raising the entire project cost through public issue. If I am going to raise the entire project cost through public issue, then this provision will not have a difficulty or it will not have an implication. Am I making myself clear? Yes, sir. Pramod, doubt? Shown. Sir, to be shown, then what is the, it should be a verifiable means. See my balance sheet, I am having fixed deposits to the extent of 70 crores. I am going to liquidate that. Investments in this company to the extent of this, if I sell it today in the market, I will get this much. That is verifiable finance. You should not just like that bring something out of the thin air and then I say this is the verifiable finance. From your balance sheet you should show these are all the things from where. Or I have entered into separate agreement with a private bank to get a loan of 200 crores. That you should show. That is what is meant by verifiable finance. Sorry. Now, my question is, can I go in for a public issue without mentioning for what purpose I am going for this public issue? Is it possible? Or let me say this way. For the general corporate purposes, we are going for public issue. For general purpose, we are going for public issue. There is a general need of funds. For the general corporate purpose, we are going for public issue. Like this, can I say? Possible or not possible? That is not possible, but there is a regulation. this regulation, what it says, see, the amount to be raised, the amount to be raised through public issue, the amount to be raised through the public issue must state the purpose of the issue. The amount to be raised through the public issue, it must state what is the purpose of the issue. However, 25% of the public issue amount, 25% of the public issue amount can be used for general corporate purpose. 25% of the public issue amount can be used for general corporate purpose. This is the maximum amount that can be used for general corporate purpose. This is the maximum amount that you can raise through the public issue for the purpose of using it for general corporate purpose. Apo, suppose my project is 100 crores, what I can do is, I can raise even up to 125 crores, whereas the 25 crores will be for the purpose of general corporate purpose, the balance 100 crores will be for the purpose of this project. Are you all with me, friends? So general purpose also I can go for a public issue, but it shall not exceed. For specifically for general purpose alone, I cannot go for a public issue. But when I am going for a public issue, in that maximum 25% amount alone can be used for the purpose of general corporate purpose. Balance amount should be used for a specific purpose or for a specific project purpose. This is the restrictions. Are you all following? Yes, sir. So these are all the basic conditions that are to be satisfied if you should go for a public issue. But basically, you need to learn some more things. If I want finance, if I want amount, from where and all I can raise this amount? From where can I raise my capital? Issue of shares. Issue of shares to whom? Public. I can issue shares to the public. Tell me who is a public. Who is public now? Public can be an individual. Public can be an individual. Individually, there are two types of individual. One is a small scale individual, the other is the large scale individual. Small scale individual, we call him as retail individual investor. What is the name of the small scale investor? Retail individual investor. Yaar retail individual investor na? An investor who is making application. An investor who is making application for shares, the value of which does not exceed 2 lakh rupees. So if, which means, if I am making an application for the purchase of shares of a company, and the value na face value le, issue value, if the issue value is not going to exceed rupees 2 lakhs, means I will be called as a retail individual investor. Suppose I am already a shareholder of that company. Now when the company is coming in for a fresh issue, for a public issue, I am making an application the value of which does not exceed 2 lakhs. Now I am called as retail individual shareholder. Where I am already having shares in the company, now when the company is coming for a public issue, again I am subscribing shares to the company, the value of which does not exceed rupees 2 lakhs, I will be called as a retail individual shareholder. First time I am making an application, I will be called as a retail individual investor. In other cases, large investor I will be. I will not be a retail investor, I will be a large investor. Are you all with me? Sorry. Next, general corporate purpose means you are not specifying for what purpose you are getting the loan. That is, for what purpose you are raising the capital. For example, sir, recently some 3 to 4 years ago, MTG Care went for a public issue for the purpose of construction of a college in Mangalore. So the total estimated cost of that college as it appeared from the prospectus is somewhere around 35 crore. So 35 crore was raised from the public. Are you all following? But sometimes what may happen, the project cost may be only 34 crores plus I need some more funds also for the purpose of administering the business or for the purpose of some other small project which is being carried on somewhere. Now this I call it as a, this miscellaneous things I call it as a general corporate purpose. So when I am going for a public issue, out of the total public issue amount, general corporate purpose ka how much I can use na? I can use only to the extent of 25%. I cannot use beyond this 25%. So this is the point to be understood. Correct. அப்படி இல்ல 125% 25% போட்டா 25 விட ஜாஸ்தியா தான் இருக்கும். 125 இஸ் தி டோட்டல் இஷ்யூ, அதுல தான் 25%, அதுல 25% போட்டா 25 விட ஜாஸ்தியா தான் இருக்கும். அப்போ அதுக்கு மேல போக கூடாது. பப்ளிக் இஷ்யூ, I am not speaking about issued capital. This issue, how much you are making out of that 25%? I am coming for 35 crores na. Out of this 35 crores, maximum 1/4, that is 25%, can be used for general corporate purposes. Beyond that, it cannot be used for general corporate purposes. Next. Can I proceed further? Sure. Next. What are the next steps to be followed? If I should go for a public issue, what are the steps to be followed? Public issue na, issue is made to the public at large, correct? Appa I need so many persons, correct? So I will appoint certain persons. I will appoint certain persons. Number one, I will appoint a merchant banker. I will appoint a merchant banker. I will say like this, sir. In a marriage, nowadays people, they don't purchase goods, they don't employ laborers, and they don't do the marriage. They give it as an entire contract. The merchant banker is like that. He undertakes the entire activities relating to the public issue. Thereby you call him as the merchant banker. How many merchant bankers can be appointed? Generally one will be appointed, but you can appoint more than one merchant banker also. But if you are going to appoint more than one merchant banker, if you are going to appoint more than one merchant banker, you should specify one of them as lead merchant banker. The book building I told you, book runner la more than one book runner is there na, one of them shall be regarded as lead book runner. Adhe mari ingiyum more than one merchant banker means then you will call him as the lead merchant banker. Appa merchant banker appadinal he is a person who will take who will take care of the entire process or the entire procedure relating to the public issue. Right. Now, if more than one merchant banker is appointed, who will share what work? Together they are liable, or they will divide the work? They will divide the work. For that, they should enter into a separate contract. These two merchant bankers, what they will do? For their division of works, this is called as inter se allocation of responsibilities. That is called as inter se allocation of responsibilities. So inter se allocation of responsibility, inter se na in between them nartham. Are you all with me? Inter se allocation of responsibilities should be entered into. Inter se allocation of responsibilities contract must be entered into. Madam, separate contract will be entered into. That appointment order or to appoint the lead merchant banker, one board resolution will be passed, you know. In that board resolution, Mr. So-and-so is appointed as the lead merchant banker and the other person is appointed as the co-merchant banker, you can specify. Next, once I appoint a merchant banker, then all the other persons who are appointed in the issue should also be appointed with the consent of the merchant banker. See friends, underwriter should be appointed. Come on friends. Some bankers to the issue should be appointed. Bankers should be appointed for the issue for the purpose of collecting these application forms, etc. Through banks also you can appoint. Bankers should be appointed. That banker should also be appointed only after getting the consent of merchant banker. Underwriter should also be appointed only after getting the consent of merchant banker. And inge we will not call him as underwriter. We will call him as a syndicate member. Book bill issue is one. Syndicate member, you will call him as a syndicate member. So I will be appointing bankers to the issue, I will be appointing syndicate member, then I will be appointing registrar. I will be appointing a person called as registrar. Who is the registrar? Registrar is a person who takes care of all the administrative activities relating to the public issue. What is this administrative activities relating to the public issue? To the underwriters, application forms and all will come, correct? Registrar or duty, he will see whether all these application forms are proper, whether these persons are eligible for allotment of shares or they are not eligible for allotment of shares. Like this, he will prepare a list. For all the persons who are not eligible for allotment of shares, he will send a letter to those persons that you are not eligible for allotment of shares. Then the final list will be forwarded to the company. And once allotment is done, this registrar will communicate with the demat account, that is with the depository, and he will take care of all those activities relating to dematerialization of the shares. Sir, this is a very big event which cannot be done in isolation by any one particular person. Thereby, we need various persons to carry on various activities. Enna activities, prima facie, what are all the activities? We need one supervisor. Who is that supervisor? Merchant banker. Enna sir? So this supervisor is the merchant banker. Now next, what should be done? When I am going for an underwriting, underwriters are to be appointed, yes or not? Here the underwriters, they are called as syndicate members. Here the underwriters are called as syndicate members. Then I need to appoint certain bankers to the issue, yes or not? So that bankers to the issue will be appointed. Abro, registrar, one person will be appointed. Who is this registrar? He is a person who takes care of all the administrative activities relating to the public issue. So all these persons I call by a common name. Yar yarla? Underwriters, that is the syndicate members, registrar, bankers to the issue, all are I call a common name. They are called as intermediaries. They are called as intermediaries. Are you all getting my point? Right. Now the next issue is how to appoint intermediaries. See, let me say one thing here. In the SEBI ICDR regulations alone, all books have not done any justification. At least the other portions in Companies Act or FEMA, some justification has been done. In fact, books like Munish Bhandari, they are very, very quality books. But even those books, they have done the greatest disjustification or the unjustification for this particular topic. What they have done is very, very simple. Whatever is given in the regulation, copy that, paste it, do some editing. So that is why if you look at this SEBI ICDR regulation, it will be there, too many words will be there, too many sentences will be there, and if you read it, you will not understand anything per se. So I have prepared my own notes relating to this SEBI ICDR regulation, wherein I have condensed this to the extent which is possible. So in case you are planning for some other material, You can go for the other material, but CBICD regulation, I feel that it will be better to read from my material, because in all the other materials, simply they have cut the bare regulations and then they have pasted. Almost all the allied laws, that is how they have done. Whether it is going to be surface E or it is going to be a competition act or it is going to be SCRA, and a bare text copy panni abdi he has pasted additional trading floor. Abdina, what is additional trading floor? That should be explained. No, what is syndicate member? That should be explained. What is registrar to the issue? That should be explained. So none of these things they have explained. So in my notes also, I have just given all these in the abridged form. In classroom only I am explaining these small intricate terms. Purinjada sir? Right. Next, appoint intermediaries. Who are registered with SEBI? Appoint intermediaries who are registered with SEBI in consultation with LMB. LMB Naira. LMB is nothing but lead merchant banker. What sir? Next. Next. Who are all the intermediaries to be appointed here? Number one, syndicate members. The syndicate members, we will call them as underwriters. No. Then they become, the contract comes between them and the other party. Why he told you that marriage, right? It's just an example. Per se, fully it will not apply here. Overall, a person, he takes the supervision of all the activities. Appointment will be done only individually between these persons. Consent of this person. இதுக்கப்புறம் எல்லாமே with the consent of LMB only. Once LMB is appointed, everything will be done only with the consent of LMB. Then number two, bankers to the issue will be appointed. Number three, registrar to the issue will be appointed. Who is this registrar to the issue now? He is the person who undertakes all administrative acts relating to public issue. He is the person who undertakes all administrative acts relating to the public issue. Next. Can I proceed? Acha. Next. We are in which step? Okay, regulation number 5 is over. Next regulation is filing of draft documents with SEBI. Next regulation or next provision is filing of draft documents with the SEBI. So next step, what is to be done? The company or the lead merchant banker, what they should do? they should file the draft offer documents with the SEBI. They should file draft offer documents with SEBI. Can you tell me what is an offer document? What is the offer document? It is nothing but, if it is going to be a normal issue, it is prospectus. If it is going to be a normal issue, it is a prospectus. If it is going to be a book building issue, then red herring prospectus. The other day itself I told you, what is a red herring prospectus? Red herring prospectus, so it is a prospectus. But what will be absent na? The details relating to the number of shares and the actual price will be absent. Only a price band will be given in this red herring prospectus. Right. When this is to be filed? When this draft offer document should be filed? This draft offer document is to be filed at least 30 days before filing the final document with ROC. At least 30 days before filing the final offer document with ROC, what has to be done? The draft offer document should be submitted to those persons. To whom? SEBI. Now what SEBI will do? So this is step number one. File all the details. Step number two, what the SEBI will do? SEBI, what it can do? It can call for information either from the lead merchant banker or from any external agency. SEBI may call for information either from the lead merchant banker or it may call for information from an external agency. What do I mean by this external agency here? Very, very simple. See, how many pages a prospectus will be? Prospectus will contain how many pages? Any idea? Minimum 500 to 600 pages will be there in a prospectus. Minimum. Bare minimum 500 to 600 pages will be there in a prospectus. So that is why you might have read in IPCC, it is not possible for a company to distribute the prospectus to every person who is asking for it or any prospective shareholder. So thereby, along with the application form shares for shares, another prospectus will be issued that is called as an abridged prospectus. So normally along with application forms, you will not have an original prospectus, you will have only abridged prospectus. If you want original prospectus, what you should do? Write to the company. Sir, I want a copy of original prospectus. Company will send you a copy of this original prospectus. So now what happens? Why this prospectus contains 500 to 600 pages? Entire information relating to the company plus some external agencies may also give some opinions, it may also give some reports, or it may also give some reviews. All these things are possible or not? Sir, I will ask you a simple question, sir. I am having a very big land where limestone deposits are available. I am in cement manufacturing industry. This land is very big, limestone deposits are available. I have taken this land on 99-year lease from the government. If I, as the managing director, say limestone deposits are available, so we are planning to expand our cement production, kindly contribute to the capital. If I give this report, whether will the public have any trust over this report? No. So thereby what I do, I contact an expert and I ask that expert to give a report or an opinion. Now if the expert gives a report or opinion, it is even more reliable. Are you all following? So if enna solron na, that external agency might have given some report or something of that sort. Yes or not? that from that external agency SEBI can ask for any information. How did you arrive at this conclusion? Like this, SEBI can ask for any information. Now, can I proceed? Next, what SEBI will do, SEBI will suggest any modifications. Now what SEBI will do, SEBI will suggest any changes or modifications to this company. So now what will happen next? The company should make such modifications. The changed or the revised prospectus, the changed or the revised prospectus should be filed with the SEBI, ROC and the stock exchanges. This changed or the revised prospectus should be filed with ROC, SEBI and with stock exchanges. Apo, the moment the company wants to file this prospectus, it cannot directly go for filing this prospectus. Before that, what the company should do, it should get this prospectus vetted by SEBI. What is that vetting? Vetting is nothing but somebody is going through the contents and then saying yes for the contents, you call it as vetting. But now what SEBI is doing, SEBI is vetting this prospectus, it is suggesting changes, but you should also include a statement in the prospectus. This prospectus has been vetted by SEBI. Vetting of prospectus in no way gives an assurance that the contents of the prospectus is correct. Are you all with me? So we right now, based on the information and explanation given to us, this is only a true and fair view. The books of accounts are not accurate. Solrama illaya yaar? Sorry. And based on representations received from the management, like that, what SEBI is doing here, yes, yes, I will vet the prospectus, but I will not take the responsibility. Vetting the prospectus in no way assures that the contents of the prospectus is correct. This statement should be there in the prospectus. I think, if possible, I will show you a prospectus. And the prospectus, la, front sheet, la, you should put about the bankers to the issue, the lead merchant banker, the book runners, all the persons' details should be given in the front side itself. That I will show you. Afternoon session, I will show you. Now, friends, listen here. So this is the entire process. Company will call for info, sorry, SEBI will call for informations or explanations from the lead merchant banker or from the external agency. After calling for such informations or explanations, what will happen? SEBI will suggest the changes or modifications. Some changes or modifications, it should be incorporated in the prospectus, and the revised prospectus shall be filed with SEBI. Next. After this, in principle approval from stock exchanges. Next step is in principle approval from stock exchanges. Sorry, what the company should do? Company should make an application to a stock exchange. Company, it can make an application to stock exchange and it should obtain in principle approval from the stock exchange. Adina, in principle approval. What is that in principle approval? Sir, shares have been issued. Whether shares have been issued here? Tell me, sir. Just now, prospectus is in the process of preparation. It has been vetted by SEBI, and just now the prospectus has reached the ROC. Yes or not? Our shares have not yet been received. So what I should do? I should get an in principle approval. See, when the stock exchange will list the shares? Only when the shares are in existence, stock exchange can list the shares. Yes or not? Upon sir, in principle approval. In principle approval is nothing but I will tell to the stock exchange, if I satisfy these conditions, come on friends, will you list my shares? Stock exchange will also say, if you satisfy these conditions, then listing of shares will be permitted. Abdin stock exchange will say, this is called as in principle approval from the stock exchange. Next, I can proceed now. Next is, certain documents are to be filed with ROC. Number one, a due diligence report should be prepared. Edhuku due diligence report? You all might have read a due diligence, no? Sorry. A due diligence report should be prepared. For what due diligence? That all the conditions that should be satisfied for the purpose of going for a public issue that has been satisfied. Abdin, you should prepare a due diligence report. Then, the board shall give a resolution. The board should give, or it should give a copy of the resolution. What resolution? The resolution which is passed for allotting the promoter's contribution. The board of directors, they should have passed a resolution for the purpose of allotting this promoter's contribution. See friends, listen here. Intercorporate loans, I told you, when the company is going in for an issue, 20% of the issue should be, or the 20% of the capital should be brought in by the promoters. 100 crores means 20 crores should be brought in by promoters. When the promoters should bring that amount, means the promoters, they shall bring that amount even before you start issuing shares to the public. Now we are in the process of going in for a public issue. Yes or not? If a draft document has come, now the draft document should be filed with ROC. I have got in principle approval from stock exchange. Now I should say, see, already promoters contribution shares have been allotted. Like this, the board of directors, they should show the resolution which states about the allotment of shares. Are you all getting my point? Next point to be understood is, there should be a certificate from a chartered accountant. For what certificate from a chartered accountant? Stating that the shares have been allotted. The shares in promoter's favor is allotted and consideration is received. We should give a certification. So even before we are going for the public issue, even before we collect the amount from the public, what is to be done? Promoter's contribution should have been brought in, and then we as chartered accountants, we should give a certificate that this has been done with. This has been done properly. We should give a certificate. So these documents are to be filed with the ROCs. Next. Can I proceed further? Sorry, I am proceeding. Next. Draft documents to be hosted in website. Draft documents to be hosted in website. Very, very simple. All these draft offer documents should be hosted in website. Whose website? Na? SEBI website. Then the company's website. Recognized stock exchange or website. And then in the merchant banker website. If you get an opportunity, go and see SEBI's website, sebi.gov.in. If you go to the SEBI website, you will find a tab where you can go and see all the draft offer documents which are being filed with the SEBI. Why this draft offer document is filed with the SEBI, or before that, when this should be filed? It should be filed 21 days before the filing of final prospectus. Before filing this final prospectus with the registrar of companies, the draft prospectus, it should be uploaded in the website of SEBI, it should be uploaded in the website of company, it should be uploaded in the website of recognized stock exchange and the merchant banker. Next, what will happen? Public comments to be received. If public is giving any comment relating to this particular prospectus, then that public comment should be received. Who will receive this now? This will be received by the LMB. Public comments is to be received by the LMB. For example, if public say the explanation which is given in page number 8, paragraph number 5 is not convincing, if the public gives now, now this is a public comment. Come on, friends. Next, what the LMB should do? The LMB should send the prospectus to SEBI along with public comments which are received. See how many mechanisms law is trying to impose on us. First, 30 days before filing the prospectus, what should be done? With the SEBI, you should file the draft offer document for the purpose of vetting by SEBI. 21 days before the registering of this prospectus, what is to be done? In the website, it should be hosted so that public comments can be received. If public is giving any comment, and if you are going to modify the prospectus, or if you are going to retain with the prospectus itself, all these things should be communicated to SEBI. No, sir. Then SEBI, what it will do? SEBI, it will give its approval. SEBI will give its approval. SEBI will also ask you to make some modifications or changes. Once those modifications or changes, etc., are done, then it becomes the final prospectus. You can go and deliver this final prospectus to the ROC for the purpose of registration. Simultaneously, you will give a copy to SEBI as well as to the recognized stock exchanges. Sir, purunjuda? Yes. Optional ekkada adu. Appointment of merchant banker is mandatory. Ipo, a final prospectus as well as the draft prospectus should be sent in a soft copy to SEBI. You are sending 600 pages prospectus, now will he sit and type so as to upload it on this on his website? So a soft copy should be sent. Sir, SEBI's website, who can upload it? SEBI only. If I upload it, it becomes hacking. SEBI's website, who can upload? SEBI only can upload. So thereby what? A copy of this prospectus. What copy? Hard copy also you should send. A soft copy should also be sent so that it will be hosted in the SEBI website. Sorry. Next, I am proceeding. This process appears to be very, very circuitous, correct? Monday or say, yeah. This process appears to be very, very voluminous, correct? Now I am asking a question. SEBI, why are you doing like this? SEBI says, I don't want any person to give some unnecessary or unwarranted information in the prospectus. Now, I am telling to SEBI, SEBI, don't think me like that. Look at my track record. Look at my past history. I have been a company who has been performing very well. I have been a company who has been complying with the statutes very well during the past so many years. So the same treatment which you are going to give to a company which is afresh coming for a public issue, and the treatment which you are going to give to me, if it is going to be same, this doesn't appear to be good. Yes or not? Yes, sir. Two companies are going for public issue. One is RML, other is RIL. What are the two companies? RML, RIL. Does any person know about this RM or RML? Nobody knows about this RM or RML. Does any person knows about RIL? Even a beggar knows about RIL, correct? Come on, friends. Sorry. Ippo, I am going for a public issue. SEBI is asking draft, offer, document, blah, 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 etc. You file to me. Come on, friend. RIL is also going for a public issue. Draft, offer, document, etc., etc., you submit to me. Now, this entire process will take somewhere around 4 to 5 months. Yes or no? Now, RIL is asking a question. Sir, you place, we both of us on the same platform. He is a new company. You comply all these formalities to him. Give some relaxations to me, sir. Thereby, SEBI has acknowledged this and SEBI is giving a relaxation. Relaxation is this. It is called as fast track issue. It is called as fast track issue. Adina sir, fast track issue. Abdinal. The in-principle approval from stock exchange, filing of draft offer document with board, in a board, no, it is not the board of directors. Act la adhu vera or periya prachana. Regulations la, at many places you would have told board, 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 you have told what we have done. We have read Companies Act. Companies Act la board means board of directors. SEBI la board means SEBI. Are you all with me? Sorry. How about this? Draft offer document, filing it with SEBI. Filing of certain documents. Like this, we discuss certain things, correct? All these things need not be complied with. It need not be complied with. It need not be complied with if it is going to be a faster track issue. Sir, just now I told you, no, certain documents are to be submitted, due diligence report is to be submitted, then promoter's contribution, the allotment of shares, that detail should be submitted, and then a chartered accountant should give a certificate about the promoter's share allotment. All these the declarations and documents are to be filed, yes or not? Now what I am saying, if it is going to be a fast track issue, this is not necessary. This is not necessary. But what is a fast track issue, sir? To call something as a fast track issue, FTI, 8 conditions are to be satisfied. To call something as a fast track issue, 8 conditions are to be satisfied. Number 1. The company is listed for minimum 3 years. The company is listed for minimum 3 years. The company has complied with listing agreement. The company has complied with listing agreement. Are you all following? In here, there is a relaxation. Relaxation in where the company has not complied with listing agreement with respect to composition of the board of directors. The company has not complied with the listing agreement with respect to composition of the board of directors. Now, this is okay, provided if it is rectified before filing the offer documents. Provided it is rectified before filing the offer documents. Understood? Listen. Have you all seen a listing agreement? Sorry. Listing agreement you can see from NSE. If you go to NSE or BSE, there you will find this listing agreement. In the listing agreement, one important clause in this listing agreement is clause 49 of the listing agreement, which speaks about corporate governance. If you have gone through clause 49 of the listing agreement, it speaks about corporate governance. I have already told you, Companies Act, he is speaking only about two types of directors. One is an executive director, the other is a non-executive director. Whereas in listing agreement, he is speaking about three types of directors. Number one, executive. Number two, non-executive. Number three, independent director. I have already told you what is an independent director or who is an independent director. Independent director means a director who is not having any pecuniary relationship, financial relationship with the company other than the sitting fees or the other remuneration which he is going to receive. Solirkena illaya, sir?
Yes, sir.
So now what happens? This clause 49 of the corporate governance provision in the listing agreement says some provisions. It says what? It says that where the thing is like this, that is, where the total board of directors is there. Total board of directors, one person called as chairman will be there, correct?
Sir.
Now what clause 49 says, this board of directors should consist of an optimum mix of the executive and non-executive directors. It should consist of an optimum combination of executive and non-executive directors. If the chairman of the board is going to be an executive director, if the chairman is going to be an executive director, one half of the board strength should be independent directors. If the chairman of the board is not an executive director, if he is a non-executive director, one third of the total board, it should be an independent director. That's what the provision says.
Yes,
corporate governance audit you have not gone through, huh? Right. Sorry. Appo, listen here. Company should be in compliance with the listing agreement, correct? Appo, yes sir, during the past 6 months, independent director strength came down. Independent director strength came down means, then the listing agreement is not complied with, correct? Now can I go for a fast track issue? Yes, still I can go for a fast track issue, provided on the date of submitting this prospectus, I have satisfied this condition. Are you all following?
Yes, sir.
Everyone, sir, totally 6 directors in the company. 3 directors are independent directors. 3 directors are executive directors or non-executive directors, non-independent directors. In the 3 independent directors, 2 independent directors resigned. Now, independent directors' strength is coming down, no? Now, something should be done, no? Suppose if you have not done anything and if it is going to continue, then this is a violation of the listing agreement, yes or not?
Yes.
Which means when there is a violation of listing agreement, you cannot go for a fast track issue, you should only go for the regular issue. Regular issue na SEBI, you should go 30 days before the issue, you should go to the SEBI for the purpose of draft document. SEBI will call the information, hosting in the website. Yes or not? Now what we are saying, if on the date of filing this offer document, if you have complied with this listing agreement requirement, though there is a lapse in the intermediate period or though there is a lapse in the preceding period, we will not consider that. Purunjada, sir? Are you all following? Next. So, inge rendu condition has been satisfied. Third condition is this. The average market capitalization is at least 3000 crores. Average na average of what? The average during the preceding 1 year. The average market capitalization is at least 3000 crores. Average na which average? The average during the preceding 1 year. Are you all able to appreciate this? Now tell me, what is meant by market capitalization? Number of shares multiplied by the price at which the shares are being traded in the market. That is what you call as market value. Wait. It should be like this. The number of shares traded in the stock exchange into the market price per share. The number of shares which is traded in the stock exchange into the market price per share divided by the number of trading days. Understood? Listen. Today, company X Limited share price is 1300. Let's go. What we should do now? Today, some 100 shares would have been bought, 100 shares would have been purchased, some transactions would have taken place now in stock exchange. So, in the stock exchange, how many shares of X Limited traded today that you should take? Multiplied by 1300. Following us, sir. Today, if some 3000 shares have been traded in the stock exchange, take that 3000 shares multiplied by 1300. This is the market capitalization for 1 day. Like this, you should take the market capitalization for the preceding 1 year. That market capitalization should be at least 3000 crores. Are you all following? That market capitalization should be at least 3000 crores. Only then the company is eligible to go for a fast track issue. Appo, object of the regulation is very simple. We don't want a small X company or a small Y company to come under this fast track issue. We only want a company who is very voluminously traded in the stock exchange during the following, friends. Everyone. Right. Next. Ella Jiseta. Madam? Yes. Details will be available with the stock exchange. No, every Saturday, Sunday is leave stock exchange. Then every public holiday is a leave. Correct. Actual number of trading days. And then you will multiply this. Next. The annualized trading turnover the annualized trading turnover is greater than or equal to 2% of VNs. The annualized trading turnover is at least 2% of the VNs. When you should see this trading turnover, adavadhu it is the trading turnover during preceding 6 months. The annualized trading turnover is at least 2% of VANs. What is trading turnover? Take the trading turnover during the preceding 6 months, annualize it, it should be greater than or equal to 2% of VANs. Understood? Listen. VANs then weighted average number of equity shares. Today 1000 shares are traded. Yesterday 0 shares are traded. Day before yesterday 3000 shares are traded. Then 4000 were traded. 2000 were traded. Are you all with me? Up and now this annualize this. So annualized trading turnover, it should be minimum 2% of the weighted average number of equity share. Adavadu the total share number of shares of the company la at least 2% of the shares should have a regular trading in the stock exchange. Purinda sir, this is a computation on the basis of the number of shares which is traded in the stock exchange. Market capitalization is a computation on the basis of the volume and the value of the shares in the stock exchange. Market capitalization, it speaks about the value. This speaks about the volume. Clear the everybody. Sorry. Above the annualized trading turnover should be at least 2% of the weighted average number of equity shares. Above during the preceding 6 months, if I take how many number of have been number of shares have been traded in the stock exchange, now it comes to at least 2% of the total number of shares of the company. Are you all following or not? Next, all promoter shares are in DMAT form. All the promoter shares, they are in DMAT form. Next. At least 95% of the investor grievances, at least 95% of the investor grievances has been settled, resolved or settled. Should I explain this point? You know what is investor grievance? Kenanga sir, shareholders will come and complain, I did not receive dividend, I did not receive annual report, there is a change in my address, you are not acceding to my request. Like this, various complaints may be made by the shareholders. It is very investor grievance. So now what you should have done, at least 95% of those investor grievances you should have settled. Then only then you are eligible to go for a fast track issue. Next. See, for the in a prospectus, what will be there? The details relating to the profit and loss account will be there in the prospectus for some years preceding this date. Yes or not? Schedule says, 2 says for the preceding 5 years profit and loss account should be there. Yes or not? Ipo. Auditor might have placed some reservations. Auditor might have placed some reservation when he has audited this profit and loss account. Correct? Management accepts, management is doing something, auditor is not accepting to that, thereby auditor is qualifying his report, he is placing his reservation. Now this auditor's reservation shall be lesser than or equal to 5% of NPAT. This auditor's reservation, it shall be lesser than or equal to 5% of net profit after tax. Abdina. Net profit is 1000 crores. Auditor is placing some reservation. The total value of the reservation which is placed by the auditor is, let us assume that it is some 2 crores. 2 crore is the reservation which the auditor has placed over the financial statement. 1000 crores is the net profit. This is considerably very, very less material, correct? Following friends, next. There may be violation of statute, material LT will see, yeah. Provident fund is not paid, this is not paid, now by material, certain things you can apply materiality, certain things scope of materiality will not apply. Yes, yes. No, no, each of those years. Year number 1, the reservation may be there. Year number 2, the reservation will be there. Year number 3, the reservation will be there. Next, there should be no pending, what to say, there should be no outstanding show cause notices issued by SEBI against the directors or the company. There should be no outstanding show cause notices which are issued against the auditors, sorry, against the directors or against the company. Sir, very, very simple. Suppose there is something which is fishy in the stock market. What the SEBI will do? The SEBI will call for an investigation. It may give some show cause notices to the director or to the company, yes or not? That should not be outstanding, which means all these issues should have been resolved. Only then you can go for a fast track issue. So where the act is contemplating about two types of public issues. What are all the two types of public issue? One is a circuitous way of a public issue, the other is a fast track issue. Circuitous way of public issue, okay, you should take the document, go and give the document to SEBI. SEBI will ask you to upload it in the website. Then SEBI will give some directions, or it will give some modifications or changes. Such modifications or changes should be incorporated in the prospectus. Public will give some comment, and that comment, if you are satisfied, you should change that comment also, that provision also you should change in the prospectus. Come on friends. Then due diligence report is to be filed. You should give a declaration that the director has subscribed to the promoter control. Sorry, the promoters have subscribed to the promoter's contribution. You should get the certificate from a chartered accountant. Very, very lengthy process or not? If you want, go through this lengthy process or satisfy all these fast track issue procedures, and you will be exempted from all those lengthy process which are given therein. Purunjada sir? So this is what we should understand about this fast track issue. Next. Underwriting. Underwriting. What the company should do? Company should appoint underwriters. Now what the law says? Who should fulfill the obligation? Underwriter should fulfill the obligation. Underwriter should fulfill his obligation. If he fails to do, merchant banker should fulfill that obligation. Give a chance, checker. What did we say? Any intermediary to the issue should be appointed only in consultation with the merchant banker, yes or not? So now what is happening? Underwriter has been appointed. A fit and proper person should be appointed as a underwriter. If you fail to appoint a fit and proper person as an underwriter, then what will happen? merchant banker should fulfill the satisfaction, should fulfill the obligations of this underwriter. Next. Can I proceed? Yes, yes. Monitoring agency see if the issue size is going to exceed ₹500 crores, if the issue size is going to exceed ₹500 crores, a public financial institution or a bank should be appointed as a monitoring agency. If the issue size is going to exceed ₹500 crores, a public financial institution or a bank should be appointed as a monitoring agency. Why? Too much of funds is coming into the company. Whether the company is properly using the funds for that particular purpose or it is using the funds for some other different purpose, that should be seen. Yes or not?
Yes,
next. Oversubscription. Who? Yes. But their responsibility is defined by SEBI. Appointment will be done there by them, responsibility is given by SEBI. That is why some outside agency, complete outside agency is appointed as monitoring agency, such as PFI or bank. SEBI. Oversubscription. What is this oversubscription? See, normally what is the understanding? When I am issuing 100 shares, how much shares I can allot? When I am issuing 100 shares, how much shares I can allot? 100 shares. Now, what the act is saying, up to 10% of oversubscription permitted. Up to 10% of oversubscription is permitted to meet the minimum lot requirement. Up to 10% of oversubscription is permitted to meet the minimum lot requirement. Understanding? See, if I want to purchase shares in the stock market, I want to purchase Reliance shares in the stock market, can I go and purchase one share from the stock market? No. Stock market normally says what is the quantity that should be purchased in the stock market. Stock market will generally say you can purchase only in 10 shares. You cannot purchase one share of Reliance. If you come to purchase from stock market, minimum how much you should purchase? 10 shares you should purchase, or 15 shares you should purchase, or 20 shares you should purchase. There will be a direction. This is called as minimum lots. This is called as minimum lots. Now suppose, let us take this small example. 100 shares I am going to allot, sir. How many shares? 100 shares I am going to allot. And I am saying that one lot will be 15 shares. One lot will be what? 15 shares. Now what this provision says, if you are going to issue 100 shares, that is if you are going to offer 100 shares, you should allot only 100 shares. This is the normal understanding, yes or not? Now here, my minimum lot is 15 shares. Apo 15, 15, 15, either I should stop with 90 shares or I can go up to 105 shares, correct? Here act is saying you can go up to 105 shares. Unnecessarily, why should I stop with 90 shares, sir? Are you all following? So thereby up to 105 shares you can go to meet the minimum lot requirement. Next. Minimum subscription. What should be the minimum subscription? Minimum subscription should be at least 90% of the issued capital. Minimum subscription shall be at least 90% of the issued capital. If minimum subscription is not received, then what should you do? Refund. Within how many days it should be refunded, na? If it is going to be, no, that is given under Companies Act. This is a different requirement here. If you are going to refund, if it is an underwritten issue, within 70 days of the closure of issue, you should refund. If it is going to be an underwritten issue, within 70 days of the closure of issue, you should refund. Normally he should take, but still what you can do, if he is not taking, there is a provision that you can refund. Act is contemplating such a scenario. Merchant banker take eduthukalen iskonga. What could be done? So now what he is saying, if it is an underwritten issue and if you have not got the minimum subscription, refund. Or I'll say this way. The underwriting contract is complete. We are not saying that 100% it should be underwritten. No. It has been underwritten. And the possibility is also there. Next. If it is going to be a non-underwritten issue, within 10 days of the closure of issue, this minimum subscription amount, it should be refunded. Can I proceed? Sorry. Next. Next comes the provisions relating to manner of calls. See, within 12 months of issue, the entire amount should be received as calls. Within 12 months of issue, the entire amount must be received as calls. However, an exception is if monitoring agency is appointed then this regulation will not apply. Sound is not a problem, but it is irritating. See, friends, what is the provision? Provision says you are making a public issue, correct? When you make a public issue, within 12 months, you should call the entire amount, you should receive the entire call amount within a period of 12 months. Suppose if monitoring agency is appointed, you can receive the calls, you can make the calls even after this period of 12 months. Yeah, logic is very simple. See, what people may try to do, no? Today they are going in for public issue. Today the company's position is good. Today they are going for public issue. But in future, to meet the future requirements also, to meet the future funds requirements also, today they may issue more number of shares, but they will collect less calls. Correct? Yes or not? As and when they require, after 1 year, after 2 year, after 3 year, as and when they require the balance call amount, they may try to make. Appo the position of the company may be completely different also. Yes or not? So thereby what the law is saying, issue shares only to the extent to what you require now. Don't try to contemplate all the future requirements after 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, and don't issue shares at a lesser call amount. Within 12 months you receive. But if a monitoring agency is appointed, when monitoring agency will be appointed, your issue size is going to be more than 500 crores. Issue size na inga face value illa. It is not the face value, it is the number of shares into the issue price. Number of shares into issue price, that is the issue value. If the issue value is going to be greater than 500 crores, anyways a monitoring agency is appointed. Correct? Yes, sir. So thereby you can receive these calls even after this period of 12 months. Ama, there is no scope of listed company, unlisted company, there is no scope. If you are going for a public issue, it should be listed. If the issue size is going to be greater than 500 crores, then you need not get the call amount within this period of 12 months. Sir, no confusion at all here. If you are going for a public issue, you should get the shares listed. There is no question of unlisting of shares, except where the stock exchange may delist the shares under section 21A of the Securities Contract Regulation Act. There is a provision, no, we read, no, before delisting, an opportunity of being heard should be given. Yes, sir. So, unless it is delisted, no other scope, listing agreement, sorry, public issue, you should go for a listing.